afternoon and welcome. I'm Karen Marsdale, president of the Greater Reading Chamber of Commerce, and we're here for another member spotlight. And I'm thrilled to have a great young gentleman who is in business, and you'll want to hear this story because it's exciting and it's something that I think we have a lot of synergy about at the Chamber of Commerce. So I'm going to welcome Elvin Rodriguez. And Elvin is part of the Oxford Funding Group.
Yes, I'm the director of funding with Oxford Funding Group. So most of you guys have no idea who we are or what we do. And Oxford Funding Group is a business loan brokerage.
So a business loan brokerage. And so that might be, to some people, well, what does that mean? And in simple terms, what does it mean?
Well, in simple terms, we assist businesses with acquiring financing for their business. And it can be anything from actually acquiring capital, working capital, to financing equipment for their business, to actually getting credit cards for their business. And we also assist businesses with building business credit, which a lot of business owners know about, but they don't know the entirety of how it works. We also assist them with that as well.
Well, it's interesting, and there's a lot of conversation that we have right now, Elvin, because we've, at the Chamber, we've just hired a young Latino gentleman who's going to be out talking to particularly Latino businesses. He's bilingual. We want to help the community. We know the growth of the Latino particularly. The entrepreneurship that's there and what we can do to help and service them. And again, along with other members of the Chamber who are oftentimes small businesses. So the majority of our businesses are small. And I think what you said is absolutely true. Many don't know how to build credit and how to do that correctly. So you're really talking about some education, right?
Well, yes, we take the approach of education. We're brokers, we work on behalf of the business, not on behalf of our lenders. So one of the things that we do is a lot of business owners, the first thing that comes to mind is, oh, why would I go with a brokerage? I can just go to the bank and get funding. And let and behold, they get disappointed when they go to the bank and they figure out they didn't approve them. The bank doesn't tell you why. They don't explain to you, hey, the health of your account is the reason why you're not being approved. You haven't been in business X amount of time. These are all things that in lending they take into consideration. So every little thing, whether it may be lenders don't like if you're running a home business, if you've been in business for 3 months, they really don't. So there's actually a stat out there that all business loans that have been made fiscal year, 2% have come from big banks, your Wells Fargo, your MMT. So the notion of, hey, I'll go to my bank and get a loan, and when you get denied, business owners are thinking there's no hope in sight. But that's absolutely incorrect. There's a lot of help, and that's what we do. Like we said, one of the things that we offer and we love to assist them with is how to get business owners to get credit cards in the name of their business. That way they can have actually access to capital. And it can be very high because it's a business. They need credit card, know that they need money. You know, American Express offers $10,000 minimal for that. But it's a process to be set up correctly.
Right, right.
And that's where they don't understand. Because if, for example, one of the biggest things is, if your social security number appears on there, you're liable for anything that goes wrong. If for some reason your business, we hope not, goes bankrupt, the creditor can come after your personal assets. Versus if you set it up correctly, they can never come after personal assets.
And how long have you been in business?
So we've been in business coming up in 1 year on October 25th. We were coming up on our 1 year anniversary. You know,
exciting.
One of the biggest things, we do business all across all 50 states, and I'm a native of Berks County. I graduated from Wyoming High School. And I love Berks County. And to me, it's mind-boggling as to why we haven't gotten the economic engine going and see activity going on. And I would love to be a part of injecting capital and resources to this area. You know, and we are a local company registered here in Berks County. And instead of institutions profiting that who knows where the taxpayers' money is going to, it's going back right into this community.
Well, I think you've said it really very articulately, and that is it's great to have young professionals like yourself seeing that Berks County is a great place to want to see growth, want to see businesses succeed. And I think we've got the combination of a lot of small to medium-sized businesses that could use the services that you provide. And, you know, we talked about the fact that we can have vibrancy, you know, in our city, in our community, in our county. You come from a family business. So you understand that, when you're in business, you're in business not 8 to 5, you're in business 24/7, 7 days a week, right? That's all the business owner. I was with a gentleman last week and he said, I don't know how I got here, but when I was 23, I was doing anything I could, and now he's a very, very prosperous business owner, very savvy. But it takes that sort of the passion in the belly. You've got to have that passion to really to, and when all else looks like it's going to be dismal, that there's something else ahead of you. So that's great. So what is it that you want to most get across to our listeners today?
To the listener is that a lot of business owners may say, hey, I don't need financing. Hey, when I do have the opportunity, I'll go to my bank. The truth of the matter is that whether you've been in business for 30 years, you're just starting, you will need some sort of financing. One of the biggest things is every business should revitalize your business and get modern with times every 10 years. That may cost a lot of money that you may be thinking, where is it going to come from? That's something where, and it actually, are very, very great loans out there for that, where you can purchase the equipment. It's called equipment financing, where you finance the equipment. And that can be, depending on the business, can be a 5-year loan.
Mm-hmm.
So it all varies. Whether you don't need it immediately, there will be a point where you may need financing for your business. Let's say you've been in business and you all of a sudden, you're a bakery, and you got an order for 100,000 pieces of loaf of bread, and you don't have the financing for that. Well, this is called purchase order. As long as you have the order for that, we can purchase that agreement and pay you upfront for that. If you're a business and you get billed every 3 months, you can get your money upfront, so you're not waiting around to get paid. There's so many options out there that it's incredible, and I think it really is a lack of knowledge.
It is. It comes down to the
like
education.
I said, a lot of business owners just get disgruntled when they go to their bank and they say, oh, well, they don't give me a loan. That to me, it really hurts, because I've been in business. I come from a third generation of family owners, from my grandfather to my parents and to now myself and my partners as well. We understand business. When you speak to us, you're speaking to business owners who understand that your finances, because let's say your business is revenuing a lot of money, you're not handling the accounts healthy. To me, that doesn't scare me. I've seen it all. I understand it. To someone else, they may look at someone and say, you can't even manage your account correctly.
Yes.
That to me means nothing. It means, hey, you need my help. You need my services.
Right. And some of the things that we always say is that if you make a great chocolate chip cookie, you're a great baker. When you want to go into business, now you're a manufacturer. So you need a little bit more expertise, and there's knowledge out there that we can all provide. So I'm getting the high sign that our time is just about up. But I want to thank you for being in here. I want to thank you for coming back to Berks County as a young professional, starting your business here locally. I think there's going to be a lot of opportunity for you. And I think one of the things we can do together is we need to educate
yes,
business owners about not to be afraid of the finances, but to embrace it and figure it out. Because once you do that, that is, that opens doors that you never thought could be opened as a business owner.
Yes.
So
lending is based on credibility. And what I tell business owners is, once you get one sort of financing under your belt, you will be good for the rest of your life.
Right.
It's always that first step that may be scary, but once you figure it out, you'll be fine forever.
Well, that's good to hear. And I am thrilled that, again, thank you for taking your time to be here today. And welcome to
No, thank
back
you
to
for,
Berks County.
Thank you for having me. It's an honor. It really is.
Thanks. It's great to have you.